that, I saw the world as colorless, never-ending black and white. It was a stream of dull colors and dull dreams and no hope. Then came you, my wife-to-be.
You are the God-fearing man and spiritual leader that I prayed for my entire life.
The way you brush your hair from your face and the way you smile, I can't wait to turn another page and follow you a thousand miles. In this world, things will change, but you remain a center stage, a sacred place.
Oh, you look so good.
Thank you.
I want to kiss you.
Not yet.
You look so good.
Thank you.
I love this dress.
Thanks. I already cried once today, so I figure we'll just let it keep happening. Are you crying?
No.
Oh, okay. I was like, dang. I love you.
Me too.
You ready?
I am. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
You're a galaxy of stars beating on my heart. You're a lighthouse on the sea, every note a symphony. You're the rising of the sky, bringing colors back to life. I see you.
Day is our wedding, and I know you will make the best bride. Today I will marry you, and I will marry you to the fullest of my ability.
I never thought that I'd meet my husband in high school, but I'm so thankful that I did, because it means even more time that we'll get to spend together.
You and I have waited so long for this day. For it to be here now shows the quality of us.
Doing life with you for 4 years has already been so fun, and I know it's going to get even better.
We have had our rough parts that only led to us being stronger. For those I am grateful, but for you, I thank the Lord for such a beautiful blessing.
You're a galaxy of stars.
We want our kids to find a spouse that compliments them, that makes them laugh. We would hear them at different points giggling.
Jay Morgan, you never fail to let others know when you're right. And I'm glad you didn't fail to let me know that I was right for you.
Pray for your daughter. Your prayer really is that she will find someone that's a godly man. And I think she's found that in Hayden. I know she's found that in Hayden.
Your future combines today with mine, allowing us to become one through Christ.
More than anything, I promise to prioritize my relationship with God so that I can be the best version of myself for you. I'm so thankful that these 4 years have shaped us into who we are today, and I can't wait to grow more with you every single day.
You're a galaxy of stars written on my heart. You're a lighthouse on the sea, every note a symphony. You're the rising of the sky, bringing colors back to life. I see you.
You two are now at a moment in your lives where we'll begin your own personal legacy.
I see you.
The devotion that you will pledge to one another today will launch you together into a new journey through life. Hayden, Jane, Morgan, you know you're very special to Terry and me. You both have a real gift, a real gift for developing wonderful relationships. As evidenced by the folks that have joined you today, take a moment and I want you to look out across this audience today. I want you to drink all of this in. This ceremony is not going to last very long. But I want you to remember as much as you can about this day and this event. Sometime in the future, you're going to look back on this day, and you're going to look back and see how special this day was. All these people that are gathered here are here to encourage you. Keep this in mind. All of this is secondary to what this event is all about.
From day one, I was able to see the perfection that is you and what you are able to do for everything around you.
You are handsome and smart, caring and patient, passionate, determined, and loving. That as your wife, I will support you no matter what. I will cheer you on through your highs and pick you up through your lows.
We all fail in life. This decision here today will always be my number one success.
I'm so excited to be your wife. I love you forever and always, Jane.
And now we're down to the part that we've all been waiting for. It is with great joy that I make this profound announcement by virtue of the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel. I'll pronounce you husband and wife. Hayden, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Hayden Spaulding.
Echoing the whisper words said, don't need another reason, I'm coming home. Home, home, home. Home, home, home. You lift me up, I'll follow you to the end of the earth. Oh, oh, oh. You lift me up, I'll follow you to the end of the earth. Oh, oh, oh. All the way home.
I felt pretty good early on when she was little because in Bible class, she would not look at men. This is great. She doesn't like guys. All right, this is a good thing. And it worked for quite a while until then this name Hayden started popping up.
It's been a pleasure growing up with you. I've been there since the beginning. Also consider you my best friend. I truly do. I love you to the moon, man.
There comes a time in everyone's life when they meet their soulmate. And that time came for Jane about 8 years ago when she met me at our high school. It's a tradition for all the seniors to play a game called Senior Tag in the spring. You have to gather your classmates' home addresses. We decided that we would bake a whole bunch of cookies and offer to drop them off at people's houses. As we were about to head home, a junior slid up asking if he could have a cookie. We figured it's on our way, why not? I don't think either of us could have predicted that when we pulled into that driveway, she would be meeting her husband for the first time. It didn't take long for Hayden to recognize the cookies weren't the sweetest thing being delivered that night. And while we had scheming plans of our own that night, I think there was a larger plan in action. Hayden, I'm so glad that I get to share my best friend with you.
You look like that movie star couple.
Just proud of you both, love you both. Just excited to see the road that God takes you on and the path that you guys go down together. Know that you guys will put God first in all things that you do, and nothing will stop you from that standpoint.
I see you.